What is it that you're doing? How are you measuring what AI is being adopted by banks?
So we published about 8 weeks ago the first public benchmark on AI adoption for banks. And what we do, it has not been done before in terms of taking outside in view, i.e. holding a mirror up to the banks and looking at their AI capabilities. So what we do is that we go and we measure the banks on the strength of their AI ecosystem, and then we rank them according to the scores that they get against the strengths of this ecosystem, which we break down into four areas: talent, innovation, leadership, and responsible AI.
Okay, so talent, bringing on the right people, the right parts of the banks you need to build up. What about responsible AI? What are banks doing about that at the moment?
Yeah, it is, I mean, on the talent and the leadership and innovation side, that's sort of really in the engine room. You know, have you got the right talent, AI, you know, dev ops and ML ops, and you look at implementation talent and so on. And on the innovation is whether you're sort of following a build or buy approach, whether you're looking at research and patents or what sort of partnerships you have. Also what you're investing in or acquiring. Mm. But on the doing all that is great, right? Looking at the raw horsepower, but doing it in a responsible manner is really critical. And especially now given the release of ChatGPT and a lot of banks and lots of other sectors too, but banks looking at how to incorporate large language models. The responsible AI bit is really important in terms of making sure that your clients, customers, are comfortable with the handling of all of this data and with the use of AI tools on that data. And it's really important to show that you're following frameworks of responsible and ethical AI as you use it.
You know, Alexandra, I appreciate the depth of the methodology. You know, in recent weeks, Caroline and I have name-checked a number of banking CEOs. Brian Moynihan, first week of March, was talking about how they're dabbling, there's work to do when it comes to modernizing banking technology with regards to AI. So who are the winners and losers on your index? Who scores highly, who scores poorly?
Yeah, well, we have, as you know, we have JP Morgan topped the index, came out number one in the index. Interestingly, Royal Bank of Canada came second, a smaller bank. But predominantly, we're seeing the North American banks in the top 10, with the European banks lagging somewhat,
yes,
and the UK banks lagging the European banks.
That brings me to my next question, which is, we learned in the aftermath of Silicon Valley Bank, or relearned, how global the banking industry is. How close is the coordination that you see between different geographies and regions in the banking system on how to implement AI across borders?
Well, there's no real coordination between the banks across. The way that implementation is happening in the European banks is quite different from the way that it's being done in the North American banks. The North American banks take an approach much more looking at how big tech is organized, so having R&D centers and being much using AI across the banks, whereas the European banks take more of an engineering approach where they're going in silos and implementing AI more in a siloed approach. So you do see differences in the approaches that the banks are taking, whether you be in Europe or North America.
And Alexandra, does any of that come down to how governments or cross-institutional viewpoints are of how to regulate, how to ethically build AI? Because many would say, actually, when you think of the regulation being developed around it, actually Asia or indeed Europe really leads the pack in this way.
Yes, I mean, the interesting aspect here is actually that the North American and Canadian banks were very visible around the guardrails that they're putting in place. And now, we have to remember that banks are heavily regulated to begin with. So a lot of this is happening internally. What we're capturing is what is expressed externally in terms of principles around explainability, responsible AI in general, and the people they're putting in place and the lines of defense across the banks that they're visible about. In Europe, you've got GDPR regulation, right? Yeah. And so there's a different, that sits slightly differently in the banks, and they're expressing the guardrails that they're putting around it in slightly different ways. Yeah. But you could say that the There are advanced thinking at the European level with the AI Act in motion right now. Mm. But because of the GDPR regulation in place, there is a lot of thinking that has been done in the European banking system.